Hi, I'm Veena and you're watching Simply Sindhi. Yesterday I was in the vegetable market and I saw some lovely fresh radish or mooli which I picked up and I thought I'd try it today and share with you a typically Sindhi dry vegetable which is a unique combination mooli and baingan ki suki sabzi. So keep watching. To make mooli baingan ki suki sabzi, you need 3 or 4 medium sized brinjals, about 250 grams, washed and cut into small pieces like I have done. 1 large mooli or radish, cut into small pieces. I have soaked this in salt water so that it removes the pungency. 1/4 teaspoon of chili powder, which is optional in case you like it pungent. 1/4 teaspoon of haldi or turmeric powder. 1 teaspoon of dhania or coriander powder, salt to taste, 2 green chilies finely chopped, fresh coriander leaves finely chopped, 2 teaspoons of fresh ginger finely chopped, 3 to 4 tablespoons of cooking oil, and 2 medium-sized tomatoes finely chopped. So let's start making mooli baingan ki sabzi. I'm first going to place this kadai on the flame, and now I'll add oil, 3 tablespoons of oil. Allow the oil to get heated and now I'm going to add the ginger to it once the oil is hot. The oil is now hot, so I can add the ginger, chopped ginger to it. I'm now going to put in the green chilies and turn them around. Now that the chilies and the ginger have been sauteed a little, I'm going to add the chopped radish or mooli. Turn it around. We'll continue to saute this for a couple of minutes. Since radish is a little harder and tougher than brinjal, we first cook this a little bit, partially cook it, and then add the brinjal and spices. The mooli or radish is now partially cooked, so it's time to add the brinjal. I'm going to mix them up well. It's now time to add the dry spices. So I'm going to add 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of dhania powder, and 1/4 teaspoon of red chili powder. This is optional. And I will mix all of this well. And now that all the spices have mixed well with the mooli and baingan, it's time to add the chopped tomatoes. Mix it well. And now we're going to add salt and 1/2 of the chopped coriander leaves. We'll leave the other 1/2 for garnish when it is ready. We are now at the last stage of our baingan mooli making. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to mix it all once again well. Place the lid on the kadai, lower the flame and cook it for about 5 to 7 minutes till both the vegetables are properly done. And then we'll be ready to serve. It's been a few minutes now that the sabzi has been cooking, so it's time to see if it's done. And I'm just going to check with putting a knife into 1 piece each of mooli and baingan. They're both perfectly done, so it's time to just give it one final turn around and shut the flame off. Our mooli baingan ki suki sabzi is now ready. This is best served with hot rotis and a katori of dahi. It also goes well as a side dish with dal and rice. I hope you do enjoy it. And if you do, please subscribe to India Food Network. We'd love to also hear from you on any suggestions, comments that you may have for us.